Hi, this is Gary U.S. Bonds, and I'll be in conversation with Jaime Wohl at 2 o'clock this Sunday afternoon at Shea 106.
Good afternoon. I'm Jaime Wohl, and this evening, Gary U.S. Bonds is making his Ottawa debut. Shea 106 is presenting him up at Camp Fortune under the stars. Last Thursday afternoon, Gary called us here at the radio station, and in a moment, we'll hear that interview. I first became aware of you back in 1976. I went to see my first Springsteen show, and I think his fourth encore was 2:45, and I thought it was a great song. I didn't know it at the time, and my friend, who's older and wiser, said that's Gary U.S. Bonds. And since then, I've discovered quite a bit about you. But as far as our listening audience is concerned, maybe you could elaborate a little bit on the early career back with Frank Gita.
Yeah, well, we had, six number ones back in the early 60s. New Orleans, the School Is Out, the 2:45, the Dear Lady Twist, the Twist Twist Senora, and Not Me. We, the bottom fell out when the Beatles came over, and here we are again.
How do you feel about the music you were recording back then compared to the stuff you're doing nowadays?
I think this stuff is a lot better. Well, naturally, technically, it's better. Musicians are better.
How much control did you have over your music back then?
In fact, we had much more. In fact, most of the songs that we did, I wrote. It didn't appear that way on paper. Most of the songs that we did in the studio was just me and the band arranging it, but it didn't appear that way on the paper. And we had quite a bit to do with it, but it just didn't come out that way.
As you were just saying about the Beatles' breakthrough, I heard a great story about how John Lennon gave you a tape of early Beatles and hoped you might be able to help him. Could you tell us about that?
Yeah, but it was terrible. It was a terrible tape. I don't think anybody could have done anything with him. I wish he had sent me the other one. I want to hold your hand. See, then I could have done something with that one.
For sure. There's been lots and lots of press about your first meeting with Bruce Springsteen in a New Jersey bar. What exactly was it like? It really didn't change your life the way they said it did it?
I don't think it was a life-changing situation, per se. No, we stuck up a friendship that night, you know. We went in and we did an album, and thank God the album is doing great. We're still buddies. You know, but hasn't been like, wow, there's a light now, you know.
Mm-hmm. Did he write you the songs once he'd met you?
Yeah, all except Dedication.
And when did that one come?
I think he had already recorded that as a demo for himself, but he told me that it sounded too much like me for him to do, so that was the initial start on the album, just going in doing that one.
I saw you live on TV a couple months ago, and I was just amazed at your stage presence, the way you just looked like you were having the best time. Do you like performing? Is that your favorite part?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's it. That's all I've ever done. That's all I enjoy doing. Well, not all I enjoy doing, but that's one of the things.
Sure. How did you you choose the rest of the songs that came on Dedication? I know you did a Beatles and a Dylan. Did Miami Steve write Daddy's Come Home for you?
Yeah, that's a great song. That's my favorite on the album. He also picked those other songs, the Dylan songs, the Beatles songs, and he wanted me to do songs that nobody would ever think that Gary Bonds would ever do.
Mm-hmm.
And I think he was successful in that, because I can't picture anybody. I can't even picture me doing a Dylan song.
Or a Jackson Brown?
Jackson Brown or a Beatle, you know. I never thought of it that way, but it seemed to work, a combination.
We'll return in just a moment with Gary U.S. Bonds, Shea 106.
All aboard!
All aboard the night train of sound.
You and CBS recording artist Ozzy Osbourne, formerly lead vocalist for Black Sabbath. Wednesday, Thursday, July 29th at 8 p.m. in the Ottawa Civic Center. Tickets at all Treble Clef record stores, including Super Clef. And at Northern Music in Potsdam, New York.
Our one-way ticket to travel with Ozzy Osbourne. Destination, the Big Rock.
Special guests are the Queen City Kids. You hear that? Know what it is? It's a tiny little paper bag. And would you believe half my summer wardrobe is in it? Really? And it's not a sundress or even a t-shirt. It's Johnson's Baby Oil. Right. Pure, gentle Johnson's Baby Oil. But I wear it with my t-shirt to help keep my arms soft and smooth all up and down. With my sundress to help hide peeling. And with my shorts to give my legs a healthy glow. Yep, Johnson's Baby Oil keeps my skin looking terrific and touchable all summer long. It even puts back some moisture that the summer sun can take away. I guess you can say, with Johnson's Baby Oil, a beautiful summer is in the bag.
Johnson's Baby Oil, you've grown into a summer beauty oil.
From Johnson & Johnson.
The thing that comes to my mind when I hear you sing is soul. Do you think you'll be singing more soul material? Or are you heading towards more contemporary stuff, like Bruce Springsteen?
More contemporary stuff. I've never really been what they call a soul singer, I guess, you know, whatever that means.
Well, it just comes naturally. What you feel is what I mean by soul, not really the genre of music, but the soul in your voice that comes out rather than just soul music.
Yeah, right. I think so.
Because in that respect, you're a soul singer. There's a lot of emotion there.
Yeah. Well, I do have a lot of that stored up.
Your alliance with Springsteen has obviously helped your career amazingly. But do you think in the future that there's a chance it might hinder it? I mean, if your next album, for example, doesn't have the E Street Band on it, do you think people might not be as interested?
No, I don't think so. I think we've already proved that. The first part of it was they wanted to see what Springsteen was doing. And now they know, but now they listen to the album and... The album is good even without him, you know, if there's such a way of looking at it that way, you know.
You're playing on Sunday up at Camp Fortune. That's an outdoor theater. Have you played outside yet?
Oh, yeah, we've done a few of those.
It should be quite a party atmosphere.
Oh, yeah.
I'm really looking forward to it, and thanks a lot for talking to us.
Oh, my pleasure, Jamie.